So, has the tech bubble well and truly burst? Something a little bit different for you in a couple of minutes. Last week, Groupon postponed its plans for a share sale, and it's not the only one. In the last 3 months, companies have been delaying their initial public offerings at the fastest rate since 2004. Actually, just want to get the views of a tech entrepreneur who has who's actually helped set up and then sold several tech companies. Now, they include Pentacom, Cisco in 2000, a deal worth more than $118 million. He sold P-Cube for $200 million in 2004 and Quamrenet to Red Hat for $107 million in 2008. He was also chairman of Mercury Interactive when it was bought by HP for $4.5 billion in 2006. Giora Yaron is now currently the chairman, CEO and co-founder of Exanet, a privately owned computer network storage company. And I'm pleased to say he joins us live from Tel Aviv Stock Exchange, where he will be the keynote speaker of a tech conference later today. Thank you very much indeed for speaking to us. So you wouldn't describe the current situation as it stands as a tech bubble, but is there then perhaps a slight degree of overpricing when it comes to tech stocks?
Well, maybe there is a slight, but again, it's something that's broken out between different segments of the tech segment. When you're talking about internet, maybe there is a slight overpricing. I don't think there's overpricing in the rest of, in the other sections. As it relates to the internet, you need to understand that there's a huge improvement in productivity that's being provided by the internet infrastructure. So if there is overpricing, I think it's a little bit, nothing huge, nothing near a bubble.
All right, what about the fact that two of the industry's hottest properties, Groupon and Zynga, are putting off their initial public offerings for now? Is that partly down to fears that perhaps these companies are not worth as much as was once thought?
Well, again, it's hard to tell, but first of all, putting it or slowing down the process a little bit until market stabilizes is the right thing to do. It's impacted by the market. It will go up and down a little bit, but it doesn't change the basic picture. There's a huge improvement in productivity when you talk about Groupon. Zynga, it's a case of a gaming kind of an application, so it's a different segment again. But all in all, you're looking at a huge improvement in productivity, if you will, or value to the end customer in the Groupon case, which really justifies a nice price.
Okay, Mr. Yaron, what about the impact of a global economic slowdown on these tech companies? Because the fact that we have seen, well, we've seen companies delaying their IPOs at the fastest rate since 2004 is now perhaps starting to suggest that they aren't as immune to a global financial slowdown as perhaps they were perceived to be.
Yeah, some of them will be impacted more than others, which is very natural. Those that do have products that play well in a depressed market will do well. Those that have products that play better in strong markets will not do as well. So I think you'll see two distributions. Some will continue to do well despite the slowdown. Some of them will be more impacted, but I don't think you can generalize by coming and saying that the whole sector is going to be hit.
Okay, so which stocks, which types of companies do you think will do particularly well in this environment?
Those that basically offer a huge productivity improvement in tough markets. Take as an example Mercury, which you mentioned earlier, which provided a BTO solution to sold to HP. We basically came into a data center and basically carried the message, you've already invested several millions or tens of millions of dollars in your data center. If you do use our tools, you will get a 30% improvement. So a company like this will always be able to sell even in a tough market and do pretty well. So there are other companies like Mercury out there that are continuing to provide massive improvement and they will do well.
Mr. Yaron, if I can ask you about the tech market where you are there in Israel, because I know that you have helped set up and then sell on several tech companies. And I spoke to the head of the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange just a couple of weeks ago, and she said, look, it is a bit of a problem that a lot of our best and brightest companies are going to list on the NASDAQ instead of there in your country.
Yeah, that is an issue. I don't think that our institutional investors are as sophisticated in high-tech investments as those that are basically overseas. It's an educational process. In fact, I'm coming from an event that took place today, which is focused on bringing them closer, if you will, to the tech segment. But I'm pretty optimistic that same as we've been successful in developing a VC industry, we will be successful in bringing the stock exchange to the level that's required. Keep in mind that today there's a vacancy in the market. Nasdaq used to be a good stock exchange for small cap and mid cap. It has now migrated into the large cap. So there's an opportunity here for the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange to basically step in.
All right. Thanks very much, Giora Yaron, Chairman, CEO, and co-founder of Exanet. Thanks very much for speaking to us. All right. So.